Now drop the wreck down. What we got? End that round. Right. That's actually looking all right so far. Now, what else have we got? There's the hands, the hooks and the stop levers, there's the ferrules. So it looks like the only part of the movement still left is the hammer and the count lever. And there's the suspension spring. And there's a pendulum leader. So we'll put, we've got to check that spring on that. And there's a little bit of rust here. I'll run over that with a wire brush, being very careful not to damage the spring. And then we'll turn the movement over. And position the hammer. And that piece of wire clips over the edge in a moment. Right. Here we go. Now, that little piece of wire there on the spring hooks in through that hole there, that tiny little hole. And is that in or not? Not. Right. Push him down, there we go, that's got him. Now we'll bend it back. Bend it up and back. Put some pressure on it to hold it in place. Right, well, we're starting to get somewhere now. That's where the hammer sits, that's the positive pressure pulling it back. We can now put this wheel on. Undo it a tiny bit so we can slide it onto the, there we go, onto the post. Now with the lever, we want that little lift lever there on the hammer to be just underneath one of those lifting lugs on that wheel so that it lifts. All right, well, we're starting to get somewhere now. We've got suspension spring, a piece here we'll put on next. You remember it had a very, very dodgy taper pin on, so we'll have to make another one of those now. This is the size taper pin we need. We'll cut the exact size we need out of that. So first thing we'll do, we don't want all that huge amount of pin there, so we'll mark a line. We want to cut all that off, and from this side we want to remove all of that. So get a cutter and cut out the piece that we want now, so we don't lose that. I'll put it into a pin vise and tighten it down. We've now got to cut the stronger side of it. There it goes. That's the end of our tapered pin. I'll move the vise up a little bit so we can see what we're doing. I'll pull the tapered pin out just a tiny little bit. Not very much, just a tiny little bit with a pair of tweezers. That'll be enough. Give us a little bit more to see what we're doing. Now, using a pivot file on this special little bit of wood I've made that's got a couple of grooves in it, so we can rest the pin in it so that it's not sort of moving backwards and forwards while we're filing it. Rest the pin. I'll put it in that one because it's a little bit smaller. The first thing we do is we square off the end of the pin. Square the end off. Right. Now, running our file at 45 degrees, we run that over the top of the pin and turn the pin vise while you're doing it. That'll give you a nice smooth 45 degree angle finish. There it is. Okay, loosen the pin vise. Take the tapered pin out. Put the end that we've just done into the vise. Tighten it down. Same thing again. Line it on a piece of wood. Square off the end of the pin first. Nothing looks worse than a rough tapered pin in a clock. Someone has just jammed one in, cut the end off with a pair of pliers, and it's all rough and jagged. Nothing says poor workmanship better than that. Right, 45 degrees. Roll the file across. Turn the pin vise between your finger and thumb. Don't need a lot of pressure. Yeah, that's pretty much right, I think. Here we go. All right. So I'll get rid of this. Take our new tapered pin out of the pin vise. Now, got our suspension spring. Push it in to the back cock and align the holes. That's pretty close. Now, where's our pin? Push it in. Yep, the taper pin goes in the second hole, not the first one. So I'll move that down and look for, that looks pretty good. Alignment on that, the taper pin back in. It's gone through, yep. Right, tighten that up a little bit so it doesn't slide out. Over the top there, wrong way up, over the top, wind it in, turn it round in the center, and then drop it over the two pins. On the bottom of the suspension spring. There we have it set up. There's a little bit of rust on that. I'll get onto that now and remove that. Well, before we do that, I'll put the cap on the top to hold everything neatly into place. It just slides on there. All right. Now I'll remove that little bit of rust on there and on one or two of the pillars.